I'll tell you what, you feel somewhat my Zachin Yaravaya strained here on Chitve Imat, on this Yam Rivii, the teaching of Torah in its most practical form of simplicity, what is needed to Beit Yisrael. So we greet you few that have joined us on the live stream of the audio visual stream that you have joined with us here in Yahshua, in the house of Yah, Yahshua's mighty name. So we do want to greet you all, and we do pray the blessings, the berakiah, the riches of his strength of knowledge rest upon you in a mighty way, that we may excel in the power of this knowledge. The more we learn, the stronger we get. And that's the way it should be. And the more we nourish ourselves, the better fit we are for the battle. And so if you don't take care of his business, how can you take care of you? It just doesn't happen that way. We must take care of the appropriate protocol that he commands us. And in doing that, then we will be supplied with all that we need to walk in the way that he commands us. It is so simple, isn't it? It is so simple that we of intelligentsia, we can't understand that. So that's why there is such diversity to things when it comes to Yah. He is Ichad. His way is simple. It is not a way that is of duplicity, complication, and hypocrisy. He has a simple way for his nation to live. He commands us to live that way. May our Abba bring our Akshimri home safely on this Kitve Imat, on this Yamri V'i. So we greet you all. I should have said to Zachin Yarabiya, you teach, but I'm going to teach tonight on a Pacific. And we'll get into the depths of that momentarily, Yisraya. It is vital that we as a nation, Shlomo, in all of the excellence of his wisdom, he did not get the understanding. Because wisdom is the reshi. It is the principal thing. Now, when one begins to grow in wisdom, knowledge of Torah, then they began to refine their bino. Wisdom is the principal thing. That is the reshith. That is the beginning of all understanding when you began to interact and experience the power of Torah. When one begins to experience the power of Torah, it is the reality in one's life. It is a sincere motive that is developed in their heart to hear what Torah speaks unto them. So that is the reshith. That's the beginning of all things. But in all of our getting, we must get bino. We must get understanding. We must get the ability to speak not only with spiritual wisdom, but intellectually. We must speak with intellect. It must be spoken so profoundly and so precise that there will be no gainsaying against you, that no one can oppose what you say. Now that's a dynamic tongue and a power of speech. When one gets the understanding. We are a nation of people that read something or hear something and we run with that without understanding. We show an example today that one of our community leaders here, he had come down to retrieve something that Ak Yabin had of his. And of course, he is one of these Christian fellows that thinks that he is so righteous. Of course, when I saw him coming in, I was at the mailbox. I said, give me a ride down. I'll ride with you. And of course, he wants to extrapolate as though that he has a knowledge. He's a very ignorant man. You understand? And so there are people that I will simply crush because they're wicked. And they think that they are wise. And of course, he began to talk, to tell me how things and the reason of things. And once he began to do that, then that kicked me into first gear. And it was all rolling from there. You see, you got talk, but you don't back it up with Torah. I will show you what I'm saying. Do you have a book in your vehicle? Now let's open that. Until literally when I finished with the man, I literally shut his mouth. He was trembling. He was so nervous. I could see his hands trembling. Well, that's the way it should be. I will not allow someone that is wicked come into this place and pronounce the wisdom of Almighty Yah here. Man that understand not the commands of our Abba, you think I will allow that spirit? I tried to break his neck in every place that I could. You know what he said after all of that? Very intriguing. This is all right. I'm open to it. Well, it's the truth. How can you not be open to it? The last of that. I want to teach tonight, as you that have joined us, I was speaking with my Ach Yosef. We working and laboring in the heat of the garden one day. And so he asked me a question. Is it important or vital that we, as a community of believers, that we gather midweek? Is not this a tradition of Christianity? So has not this been induced by the religious observation of their own concern as to what a gathering of congregation represent, or in essence, in their term, is this the way, quote, the church, unquote? Do they not do it like this? So is it that you're moving away from Kitve Imants, and then it is only on the Shabbat? Well, I'm going to answer that question tonight for my friend. And I want to title this message, Christian Tradition, or Yahweh's True Worship, or His Way. Is this service tonight, is this part of the protocol of what we call Christian tradition? Is it something that was introduced by what we know as Christendom, this false delusional religion? Or was it from the beginning? Can I find empirical evidence in Scripture that it talks about having gatherings not one day but every day of the week for the span of 3 years, 2.5, for the span of 1.5 years every day? It is an ignorance of anyone to think that this is some form of Christian activity, because you think that those Achim went into countries and preached only on the Shabbat. They gathered every single day, and they worship every single day. And I will prove that point and give resolution to my friend. All right, but I want to begin here. I want to establish this protocol here in the book of Marcus. In the book of Mark, chapter 7, and verse 9. That's why I began with that expression of the mashal, or the mishli, the proverb, where it says that wisdom is the principle. We must understand that's the reshith. That is the first principle. That is the first order of business. Wisdom is the principal thing, but in all thy getting, we must get understanding. That is to extrapolate from Scripture, from Torah, to have the wisdom of that wise speech of saying that you can speak intellectually and you can back up what you say by what Torah says. And you can prove the point by Torah, not with some ignorant statement that you believe or you have heard others to say, or you have determined that within the context of your ignorant wisdom. It is not so. I want to begin here in the book of Mark, chapter 7, verse 9. Yeshua says unto those that were the intellectuals of the spiritual knowledge of things, Yeshua said to them, full well, this is what he says, you have ga'al, you have rejected, you have despised, you have cast it away as vile, you have rejected the mitzvah, the commands of Yah, that you may keep your own traditions. You may keep that which is tarthach,
And a tradition, when he expressed this in this character, he is talking about tarthak, that which is demonically induced in the mind of one. It is a speech of darkness because it has no light of Torah's wisdom. When one make a statement like that, you can see the darkness of that individual's understanding. So he uses the word tarthak. There's a deep darkness of understanding in that one, because one is relying upon tradition and traditional speech. What one has heard others say, that they will say that this is a part of what we call the church tradition. I want to lay out these principles first of all. He says it is that of your tradition, and these individuals that talk like that, well, the power of his mitzvah is void in their lives. There's no light, no sign of the excellence of the commands of Almighty Yah. Well, what constitutes a gathering of his people? Is it because we're gathered here in this building? Is that the ohel, the congregation of Yah? Well, Yahshua points that out to us in the book of Matthew's Matithiyah. And then I will get into the depth of this teaching. He points out in the book of Matithiyah, Matthew's 18, verse 20. He says, for where there are two or three, he used the word asaf, gathered. They have assembled themselves to receive, to take heed to the knowledge of Torah. He says, where there are two or three gathered in my name, there am I also in the midst of them. So if two or three are gathered under the power of that precious name, Yahshua HaMashiach, he says that is the constitution of a gathering, an assembly, be it a house of worship. It doesn't take 10 or 10,000. Two or three gathered in his name. So when there's a gathering in a home of those in his name, then that is the constitution of an assembly of Yah. I don't want to point that out. I want to show you what days they gathered on, all right? And I want to begin. Let me read this here in the book of Maaseh Shlishim. In the book of Acts, chapter 11, I want to just start here. In the book of Acts, chapter 11, I want you all to maintain these scriptures, all right? Acts chapter 11 and verse 25. I will get into the specifics, all right? Then my ach will have a clear understanding when I finish. It says here in Acts, the book of Acts 11, 25 and 26, it tells us that Barnabas and Shaul, he departed to Tarsus. He was seeking Shaul. Verse 26. And when he had found him, he brought him to Antioch. That's where he took Shaul, to Antioch. And it came to pass that the whole year, do you all hear that? Not part of the year, not on the Shabbat, but the whole year they assembled themselves with the assembly. Now, in your translation, it may say church. For 1 year and a half, for the whole, every single day. Not just Shabbat. It says for the whole year they assemble themselves with the assembly, and they taught much people. They taught the people day and night, every single day. Literally, the house of Yah should be open every day. There should be knowledgeable, wise Zachin that can come in and speak if it's one or two for the refreshing of knowledge and understanding. It should be open every single day. The wise men should gather in the plaza in the cool of the evening, and they should speak of the wisdom of Yah, and their voices shall resonate among much people. And they taught for one whole year and a half.
Well, it doesn't say that they taught every day. Well, we'll get to the depth of it. Don't worry. And they assembled for the whole year. They assembled themselves with the assembly, and they taught much people. And the Talmudims were called at that time, they were called ignorant individuals. That's what the word Christian means. When you search it out as its French form, it means a stupid, unlearned, unknowledgeable individual. And that is where they were called Christians, first in Antioch. Is this a tradition of Christianity? The gathering, the first day, the second day, the third, fourth, fifth, even on the Shabbat? Should the gathering of Yah's people just be on the Shabbat? There is nowhere in Torah where it points to anything but every day, because the Kohan, the Gadol HaGadol, the Gadol Kohan, the high priest, he offered up the offerings every day for the sins of the people. Every day. Every single day. Let's proceed here. In the same book of Acts, chapter 17, verse 10. And this is Shaul, he's there at Thessalonica. And he's speaking unto a wise council of men, the Bereans. Now this is what a wise man will do. This was the beauty of the Bereans. There were men that were able to hear, to receive, and then they would search the Torah daily to see if these things were of great validation. It says in Acts 17:10, it says, and the Israelites, Achim, the brothers, immediately they sent away Shaul and Silas by night to Berea. Who's coming there? He went into, it tells us he went into the house of Yah, doesn't it say that? He went into the Beit. He went into what one would say the synagogue of the Yahudim. He went into the place of worship, the place of instruction, the place where the Torah was taught. It says, now these were more noble than those in Thessalonica. They were much wiser. These men were resound in their desire, their passion, and wisdom. It says they were more noble because in that they received the word of Yah with all readiness of mind. And they searched Kitvi HaKodash daily. Now I want you to remember that word. If they did it daily, that it means they did it every day, right? Is that not what the word yom mean, daily? They searched the scripture daily, whether those things were so. And the reason they searched it to find whether they were so, because they were astounding unto their knowledge. They didn't know. They had not heard the revelation of Torah in the way that Shaul and Barnabas had extrapolated from that stroll, that sefer, the writing of the book. And so they searched daily. That is one thing I want to draw your attention to, that one word, daily. We must learn that we cannot obfuscate words and their meaning. We cannot look over every precise word, because every word that Yah speaks, it is pure. And the servants of Yah love it. Now these men were devout men. These men searched the Torah daily to see if these things were true. Drop down to the 17th verse now. I want to continue. This is Shaul. He's there in Athens preaching the same truth. And I want to show you the consistency in Torah, and that we can relate to that word daily as to what it implies. Acts 17, verse 17, it says, therefore Shaul, he disputed in the tabernacle with the Yahudim and with the devout persons, and in the market he did it daily with them that met with him. Yahushua said, were there two or three gathered in my name? There shall I also be in the midst of that. So this was a daily exercise,
teaching and learning and exalting and worshiping. Yeah, it was not relegated to the Shabbat. The Shabbat was a time that through the process of the daily teaching that we come into the house of Yah and we rejoice in those teachings. You didn't need to be taught on the Shabbat. It was a time of reading of the Torah. It was a time of singing and dancing. Daily now, remember, daily. He disputed with them in the market, in the plaza, daily. They conversed in Torah. There were thorns of crops. So you tell me the first assembly of what people will call, quote, the church, unquote. You tell me it was in a building? Or was it outside with Moshe there in the midst of the wilderness? You tell me those that are the diaspora, when they came to this nation and they gathered in that powerful name, when they would hear the dialect of that name, you tell me they had buildings to gather in? We have confused things. This is not the tradition of this whore. This is the way of Yah. They did it daily in the market. They gathered the devout men that they were intellectually strong. They had strength. They had strength of wisdom. They had the beauty of wisdom. And when they spoke, their voice, the volume of their voice rose in the market. And it disquieted everyone, and everyone would give their ears attentively to what they were saying. You don't find that today. You find unfruitful elderly men. Why? Because they don't search the Torah daily to see if Torah is true. Men search it to prove out their wisdom when they have no wisdom at all. I'm going to proceed. Is this Christian tradition or is this the way of Yah? Hallelujah. Now again, I emphasize the word daily. Give us Yah our daily bread. Does that mean that the bread you prayed for yesterday, now, is that not part of our prayer? Give us this day our daily bread. Now, remember that daily bread and the breaking of bread, because these words are vital and important. And what I want to point out to you tonight, all right? Hallelujah. You look at the 20th chapter. When Shaul, Acts 20, verse 28. Do you think that these men were defying what Torah? If Torah taught only to gather on the Shabbat, then these men would have been defying that. That this is what Shaul says in Acts 20, 28. He tells us to take heed. We are a generation that will not take heed, therefore, to who? Yourself. That's what he says. He said, take heed, therefore, to yourself. We are a generation. It's one thing that I've learned in life, honestly. I've had men to say things to me, and I knew that they were absolutely wrong in their statement. But I did not challenge them as to what they said. I would hear what they say, and I would say, Yah, don't allow that to be in me. Because when a man's heart is pure, he that is pure, when a man's heart is pure, everything to him is pure. To him that is defiling, unbelieving me, you can't tell them anything. I've had men to say, you're this and that, and I would not even argue. I say, okay, Yah, I'll listen. And just hear that. Because even if I'm not that way, then it will produce wisdom and more wiseness in me that will be discerned by those that don't even know Yah. We will not receive any kind of correction, but we are apt to correct someone else. And we're not, that's not me. Oh, go ahead, man. Listen to what he says now. He tells us to take heed to yourself and to all the flock over the which the Ruach HaKodesh has made you overseer, to do what? To feed the congregation, the Ohel of Yah, which Yah has purchased with his own blood. Now this is the heart of Shaul. He says, for I know this, I know that after my departing, he says, shall grievous wolves enter in among you, not sparing the flock. Now this is what this man did day and night. He says, also, from among you, your own self shall men arise. He says they go to speak words that are ichesh. They're going to speak perverse things, unlearned things. And they're going to try to draw away those under their discipleship after them. He says, therefore, watch. He said, I want you to remember that by the space, by every day, by the space of 3 years, listen. You tell me those 3 years that Joshua preached, you think he just preached on the Shabbat? I will show you daily he was in the tabernacle, disputing and teaching and extolling the Torah of Yah. It is just so silly. He said, 3 years, I did not cease. Well, he did it 1 hour in the morning. Well, this is what Shaul says. I cease not to warn you, everyone, night and day. That's what he did. He said, night and day I preach. Night and day I warn the people. We don't want nobody to warn us. We don't want nobody to speak anything that will warn us of our ills and our inability. We don't want that because we think highly of ourselves. We have no ability to esteem others. He said, for 3 years, every day, and they gather. They gather in the market. The daughters of Tizayon, they prophesy Nabah. They play the timbrel. They sing and they gather themselves together. And this man would declare the power of Torah. He did not wait till the Shabbat. And then when they were here, this was the course of all the week and the day, hour-long sermons. Then on the Shabbat, they were gathered there in the Ochel, the congregation of Yisrael, and they would sing and dance and rejoice greatly. Then sometime in that evening, I will show you the account. Shaul began, the Hefa began to preach, and they will preach all night into the first day, into the second day. This is not a tradition of Christendom. Yah established this from the beginning. This was from the beginning, Yisrael. We should have service every day. There should be a gathering of Yah's people in the morning to hear the Torah of Yah, to arouse their hearts, to be strengthened, to go forth. There should be a gathering in the evening. He divided our lives into three segments of eight. 8 hours of sleep, and we need that. And 8 hours of work, we need that. And 8 hours of our companionship and gathering among Yisrael. We need all of that. And that is the strength of any nation. Well, I like being by myself. I don't want to be by myself. He gave us 8 hours for each of those activities. Can I go a little farther? Did he say, day and night I warn you? Isn't that what the Torah is to warn us? Did he say, day and night he preached? He preached day and night. Day and night. He preached daily. They assembled themselves daily. They assembled themselves in the plaza. They assembled themselves in the gathering of the field laboring. They assembled themselves on the tabernacle every day. Every day. And he preached. And he taught. And Joshua preached every day. When he would go to a place, the throngs of people would gather around him. Is that not an assembly? Or it has to be some kind of canvas or some kinds of walls to call it an assembly? An assembly, just what it means, a gathering of the people in a location for one purpose. It is assembling of people, the gathering of a people. Whether it's two or three, it is still an assembly. So day and night, for those 3 years, like Shaul, that Joshua HaMashiach preached for those years. Day and night, he preached. He did not take one day off, Yisrael. He preached. Listen to this then in the book of Acts, chapter 20. Look, go back to the 7th verse. Now this is what it says here, Acts chapter 20, verse 7. It's appalling to hear the ignorance of the Kiddushim of Yah. How we think and what we, the trash we still have in us. And we think we're wise. It's sad. Look what it says in Acts 27. It says upon, does it say the first day? So we know what the first day is. It's the day we call Sunday, isn't it? It says upon the first day after the Shabbat, when the disciples, the Talmudim, came together to do what? To break bread. The breaking of bread, the eating of the lecture. Give us this day our daily bread. When they came together to break bread, it says Shaul talked to them or he preached to them. It says Shaul preached to them. So that's where a lot of Christians think that was on the first day he began to preach. Now he had taken care of business on the Shabbat. So it makes no difference. We should gather. We should do just what the mitzvah commands us. Remember Zakah HaShabbat. Shema Kibet Kado set apart. That we rest in all we have learned during the week. You know, it's amazing because in the course of 6 days, our minds are so removed from Yah. We got every kind of filthy, coarse, and unclean thing coursing our mind. And then when it comes to the Shabbat, we bring sin into Yerushalayim, into the city of Yah. We bring our own ills, our own attitude, our own spirit, and it's wrong. We should bring no burdens into Yerushalayim. We shall have no order against anyone on that day. You understand? So we cease from all of our labor, trying to love someone, trying to be kind. We cease from all of that because we have been refortified in the hearing of the Torah daily. And then when we gather in Yah's house, there's a great sound of melodies and rejoicing before Yah. So that's why we can't rejoice, because we're not getting our daily bread. We're getting daily trash, but we're not getting daily bread. So the ark, they gather together to break bread, to eat. Well, that doesn't mean that. Well, I'll prove that out too, all right? They gathered to break bread, not only to consume the physical food, but above all to consume the bread of life. Is Yahshua not this bread of life? He is the bread of life. Yahshua is. He is the Lashem of Chayin. And so we need this daily bread. We need this daily feeding of Torah. We need that. We need to hear the elders speak with such elegant of wisdom and understanding of intellect. Such a resounding authority in their voice. And not hedging and heeing and hawing. But it must be done with precise precision. And you can't get that way unless you daily search the Torah and see the wisdom of the Torah. And see how true Torah is. Not trying to prove what you are. You're not worth a damn. Any of us not worth anything. Your wisdom is not even like a grain of salt, man. If you had such profound wisdom, you would see that. You had such resonance of strength, everybody would see it. Don't be silly, man. We don't want to see our sister. Well, no, I'm not there. No, if you had it, everybody would see it. When a woman thinks she has a physical attraction, everybody sees that. When a woman thinks she has those physical attributes, everybody sees it. When a man is charming and regal and handsome, everybody sees it. Even another man sees it. So it is with the spiritual things of Yah. We're an ignorant people. We are ignorant. It is sad how ignorant we are. No, that's not me, man. No, it's not you. I'm glad that it's me. I'm glad that it's me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They broke bread. And Shaul preached to them. So was that the first day he preached? Sure was. That's what it said. He preached to them. So then, is it wrong to assemble on the first day? No, it's not wrong. It's not wrong for you to assemble. We must remember the Shabbat and keep it kadosh. You can assemble on the first day and have a nice preaching and go out and work and pick beans and cook and do all of that. You can assemble on Tuesday and then you, after the assembly, you go out and work. And it'll give you more energy to work. You energize. You have the esprit of Yah. That's why we need to be fed the daily bread. We're fed the daily bread of folly and foolishness. We have this consumption of just things that are of no value, Yisrael. And that's just a fact of the matter. And we must come to the reality of that. We should gather every day. We should hear the Torah of Yah. We should every single day. Well, what is that of any value to me? All right, in the second chapter of the book of Acts, verse 42. And then I want to drop down to verse 46. Now we know that this account when the Ruach HaKodesh was poured out, the Ruach, Yah, Ruach is mine. It says in Acts 2:42, the book of Acts, Me'aseth Shulishian, the Acts of the Apostles. It says in verse 42, and they continued steadfast in the teaching and the doctrine of the Shulishian, of the Apostles' doctrine. And does it say, and fellowship? Does it say fellowship? Isn't that what the assembly or we gathering is it about? Isn't that what gathering is to fellowship? Yeah. It says in the fellowship and breaking of bread with prayer, with tefillah. That's what they did continuously. They continued in fellowship and breaking of bread, gathering and hearing the Torah. They continued in the doctrine. They were steadfast in the teaching of Torah and the wisdom of the Torah and the revelation of that truth that was written by Obadiah, Yeshaya, and all of the mighty messengers of Almighty Yah. And in verse 46, it continued. And they continued how often? Does it say daily? It says daily with one accord. Where? In what? In where? You know what it says. They continue in Beit HaMikdash. In the house of Yah, they continue daily. They continue daily. They continue daily. They are preaching daily. They had the Shulishim preaching daily. One get up and preach. He says, the other get up and preach. And this one slip out and take care of the cows. And another crowd comes in. And then Kephar preach. And then when he leaves, Thaddeus gets up. Come on, Yisrael. That's how they did it. Kephar gets up and preach 3, 4, 5 hours. Uzzah came, well, I got to tend to them cows. It's second day. He goes out. He can't wait. He goes out and tend to them cows and get everything done and get that chicken house up. He said, Mama, get me a pot of water. Come on, let's go. He washes up and he goes back. And by the time he gets there, there's Bartholomew preaching. Then he said, I got to take the youngest home and lay them down. He takes old Sipporah and set her home and lay them down and say, baby, I'll be back. I'll be back. And then when he gets there the next time, it's Marcus preaching. They continue daily, night and day, preaching and teaching every day. That's how they did it. Then old Yeremiah on Shabbat, he said, oh, sun's going down, let's get ready. And he would go to the house and they would dance, shout. And old Kephar couldn't get up and say anything. Kephar couldn't get up and say anything. Thomas, he just waited and rejoiced because it was a time of great rejoicing. And the Kohan began to read the scroll, the Torah. The people were just overtaken with that. That's the way it should be, Yisrael. When we hear the magnificent power of this truth that our hearts are overwhelmed, they become enriched, they become powerful, become pulsating with the wisdom of understanding when you hear it out of the mouth of the messenger of Yah. It said they continue daily. They continue daily with one accord in the Beit HaMikdash. They were in the assembly. What? Breaking bread. See, they went from house to house, teaching and exalting and preaching. That's why Yahshua said he knew the power of his mind would be poured out upon the people. So he let them know we're 2 or 3 gathered. I'm going to be in the midst now. You go to that house, 10, 15 there, down the street there, 78 over there. There's and the Ruach, the mighty speaking the same thing to them all. Breaking the bread from house to house. And they did eat their meat with gladness and with singleness of love. Well, that doesn't mean they were worshiping Yahshua. Huh? It says in the next verse, praising Yah. Do we come here to praise Yah? It said, praising Yah and having free unmerited love and favor with all the people. And Yah added. And Yah added unto the hell the congregation daily. Did he add just on the Shabbat? It says he had daily. It said he had daily, daily, such as that should be delivered. They had service every day. Every single day they gathered. And they preached. And the babies were asleep, and mama missed meal, and daddy missed meal, and daddy had to go out to the cornfield and harvest his wheat. Yet he would get back. He would go from that place to the house. He could hear the sound of the shofar. He didn't have to walk far. And there was the same Ruach speaking in that house. He could sit there and break bread. The widow on her way journeying home, and she hears the singing coming from the house, and she barkens and bark upon the door, and there they were singing and praising on the power of Torah being exalted in the midst of them. They woke up in the morning, they hear the sound of Torah everywhere. Silly. If anything, the whole house got us beat out. The whole houses that open every single day. The whole houses that open from Sunday to Sunday. Monday's open, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. They open every single day. They open every single day. Every day. You go to the Catholic whorehouse, they got a priest that giving out penance and bread and that false thing every day. And people go there. In every city, they do it. They have communion every day. Every single day. Their cities every day. There are people that they call themselves devout Catholics, and they take that lot every day. I don't care if they're in Chicago today and New York tomorrow, they find a whorehouse. They can be in Phoenix the next day, in LA the next one. They find them a house that they will take communion. There's a sportcast broadcaster named Dick Vitale, college basketball. And I remember 10, 12 years ago hearing this man say, there is not a day passed in over 30-some years. I don't care what city I'm in. I don't care what airport I am in. I do not go into the chapel, into the whorehouse of church, and have my daily communion or my confession. That's what the gathering is all about, confession. Confessing our faults one to another. That's a whole different teaching. Hallelujah. But of course, we don't have no faults. Oh, that's not me, preacher. We don't have no fault. I disagree with you. I know you disagree with me. You don't disagree if someone says, oh, Ray, he's got tough love, doesn't he? What in the hell is tough love? We're silly. We are silly. We are silly people. We don't want to say we're silly. We're silly. We're so unlearned. Yes, we are. That's why we need to be taught every day. Yeah. Your mothers, do you just teach your children once a week, or you teach them daily? Is it an all-day job? Sure it is. It's an all-day job. We're children. Are we not the children of Yah? It's an all-day job. We have to be reminded. Do we have to be reminded? All the time. We'll forget what's taught tonight. We can't remember what Zachain preached Shabbat before last. Let me move a little farther. Well, that's not enough empirical evidence. Okay, well, I'll move a little farther. They continue daily. And Yah added to the congregation such as should be Yosha. Well, look at the fifth chapter, Acts chapter 5. Beginning at verse 41, Acts 5. This is when the mighty Shulisham, they testify before the council. This council concerning the Sanhedrins, concerning the power of the HaMashiach. Acts chapter 5, verse 41. It says, after they had done that, they departed from the presence of the council, rejoicing that they were counted worthy to suffer for his name's sake. All right. And it says, and daily. Does it say daily? Does it say on the Shabbat or daily? And daily in where? In the bed. Some translations say church, but daily. Does it say daily or just one day? It says daily, doesn't it? It uses the word yom. And daily in Beit HaMikdash and in every house, not only in the assembly, but in every house. And they cease not, and they cease not, and they cease not to teach and preach, and they cease not. Does it say that? Is I making something up? It's an ignorant assumption. And ignorant men, they have no learning of matters. And they will say anything that their tarcha, the wickedness of their mind, will make them say. It says, and they cease not to teach and preach Yeshua HaMashiach. Did they just do that on the Shabbat or daily? It says they did it daily, Yisrael. Not only did they do it in the assembly, but when they went to that house, there was someone there preaching. And then when they heard it over their house, there was someone preaching. When there are two or three in that house, they gathered themselves with five or six over there, and all of a sudden the house was bursting out the seam. As it had come with Kepha, that the man fell down. And the prayer of the righteous, it was the first day he fell down. He had preached all Shabbat, all that night. It did not say they preached this on the Shabbat. They preached daily. It was a constant thing. This must be constant in our lives. Daily they preach. Daily they gathered at the house. And when the house was packed, there was one over there preaching. Because they preached the same thing. They declared the same truth. There were men of great wisdom that had the power to resoundly rebuke them. And they preached in the power of that name, Yeshua HaMashiach. Had a young man to write me the other day. Well, I would ask you a question. I'm just coming to this knowledge. I see that the men there, they wear their hair like this. I won't even answer him because he's stupid. Here you're just coming to the knowledge of the truth. You need to be dealing with your damn sins, man. Understanding what sin is. You worried about how we have trimmed our beards and all of that? This is a stupid generation. I won't even answer. Not going to waste y'all's time. He already has an opinion. That's why he wrote. I'm glad he said they preach daily. That's why I pointed that word out in the beginning of this teaching. Daily they did it. Daily, not only were they teaching Lomad to instruct in the way of Torah, but they did it with the preaching of the Bozerach, with the authority of power, resoundingly. Daily they did it. Daily. If it's anything, this wicked whorehouse has emulated what should be done among Yisrael. They preach daily. Is Yahshua coming? And that's why they were doing it, because they were waiting for the promise of the coming of HaMashiach. That's why we pray, give us this day our daily. And everything I've been reading, they've been breaking the bread daily to get the bread of life, the lechem. And the Kohan stood daily, all day, offering up the offerings unto Yah for the sins of the nation of Yisrael. It's silly. No, we're not stopping. We just got a lot of work and we just been so busy and tired. But we will never do that. Matter of fact, we need to do it 2 or 3 more times a week. And if those that think they're wise, if they will be studious and be students of Torah, they can teach not with ignorance, but to stand with the authority. And when you speak with, you pronounce things with authority. You know what you're saying. You should have seen that man today. He was trembling. Where is that? I said, here it is. Give me your book. Here it is. Read that. He didn't dispute me. He took a pen and he marked around those verses, put a piece of paper that said, now take that to your pastor and show him. Take that to your Baptist preacher and show him. Ask him. Oh, he's a beautiful man. I said, well, tell him come down to see me then. Tell him come visit me. We're not in a cult. If you know what an occult is, tell him to come. I was talking just like that too. With them that coat down there, silly boy. They're stupid. Maybe the Shabbat, I'm going to read the definitive of a cult, its etymology, its origin. This is a stupid generation. And I showed this man today how stupid he was. He was stupid. He was ignorant. His grammatics, his speech was just horrendous. Moving on, Yisrael. Daily, first of all, in the house of Yah, and daily with each other, were they not? They were daily with each other. Shaul speaks here that how he preached in 1 Thessalonica. Move that quickly. We're going back to the book of Maaseh Shilishim, the book of Acts. But I want to read this because this is the account here. In the book of 1 Thessalonica, chapter 2, verse 9. He says, for you remember, brother, he's talking to the Yisrael, the Ach of Yisrael, the Yisraelite Achim. He said, you remember, brother, our labor and our travailing. I want you to remember how we labored, how we travail in the wisdom of Torah. 1 Thessalonica 2 and 9. 1 Thessalonica 2 and 9. He said, for laboring night and day. Now, there are those that would say, well, that means he was working. That's silly. Shaul was not setting up, making no tents night and day. He said, we labor night and day. Night and day in Torah, because we will not be chargeable to any of you. We preach to you. That's what they labored in night and day. We preach to you the message of Almighty Yah. And they did it night and day. They labor. They preach. They extol. They expounded on the depths of Torah. They didn't lay around 10 hours a day sleeping. He labored night and day that there was nothing you could charge me with that opposed the Torah of Yah. In this revelation of Yahshua HaMashiach, you are not going to be chargeable to us to say, well, that's wrong. That's a wrong interpretation. He said, we labor night and day, every day, every day we preach. Every day declaring the power of this total truth unto you. And we were not chargeable to you. You have no sin. You can lay to our charge. We did not deceive any of you all in the work. It was day and night. Don't you know in the illness of us, Yisrael, we need to hear this day and night. We need to hear Torah day and night. We hear enough of this folly of the world that infuse our minds and develop our concept that we are sick. We're sick in everything. You can't even correct someone that think they're wise today. You correct the wise man, then he loves you. He say, okay, you speak to a wise man. Wise man hears what one says. You say something to one that is simple and foolish, you will get yourself a block. It's almost, can I show an example? It's almost like saying, my wife said to me, your belly is big. No, my belly ain't big. Come on, get real, hypocrites. Don't tell me we don't do that. Oh, your belly is, oh, real, that looks bad. What are you talking about, woman? Woman, shut your mouth. Talk to me. Still big woman, you better be quiet. Go ahead now, woman, just leave me alone. Stop that. Don't mess with me. Someone says something to you like that, you tell me you want to respond like that, that's the way we are. We're just that way. Instead of saying, yeah, you sure are right. Help me, just, whew, you tell the truth. You're right. You look fat, man. I ain't fat. Look. I love you, son. You know I do. I remember your father one day. He was in the mirror. He's a big man. He's about 400 pounds then. He had a blue suit. I'll never forget. Double breast. And he's standing there. We had some mirror that he's standing. He's just looking at himself. And I said, you're still a big man. Rayaka. You see, you big boy. You overweight, man. But you could not tell him he was on a gym of apparel, man. He just looking like, see, we don't want to hear that. We don't want to hear him tell us that. I couldn't tell him. And he strolled out of there and I looked at him and said, man, stop it.
You look a mess.
That's the way we are. Well, that's not me. I'm wise in the Torah.
You are
wise. Hallelujah. Turn quickly to the book of Acts 8:3. I'm going to finish this tonight. I got a lot of scripture, but I want to finish this. I want to have empirical evidence. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to, in the book of Acts, chapter 8, verse 3 and 4. Quickly, I want you to understand this scenario here. This is when Shaul, now the same one that I've read what he said in Thessalonica, yeah, he goes and persecute the assembly of Yisrael. It says in Acts 8 and 3, and Shaul, he made havoc, wreck of the congregation. Entering into, now see, he made havoc of the congregation. Does it say that? Now, what does and into every house? And they went from house to house breaking their bread, did they not? So he made havoc in the congregation and also into every house. And he began to hail or to seize men and women and committed them to prison. Listen, therefore, they that were scattered abroad, they went everywhere and they preached the word. Those that escaped the brutal hand of Shaul, they went everywhere and they preached the word. So you tell me that they went and preached on the Shabbat. Just even the logics of wisdom and understanding of Torah will let you know that they preach every day. Every town, their scriptures say, every town they enter, they preach. Every hamlet, every city, they preach day and night. So those that were scattered abroad, you tell me they went and just held service on the Shabbat? Or did they teach every day? They taught every day. And they went from house to house. Shaul did not just go into the congregation and rest though. He went to the houses because they were gathered in the houses breaking bread. They were gathered in the houses. That's when no man had nothing that he called his own. He brought it all because they had given up everything for the sake of Yeshua HaMashiach. For they looked for the expedient coming of our HaMashiach. And they went everywhere and they declared the power of this. They taught and they preached everywhere, every day, every night they preach. It was no lights out in that day. In Vatican cities, it's lights on 24/7. There's some sound or something being taught or said in that city. There are those that come from all over the world. Vatican City, someone in every corner preaching something. Believe me, whether they're Christians or Catholic, whether those that oppose the Pope or what, they went everywhere. They went everywhere and they preach the word of Almighty Yah. Well, that doesn't tell me anything. Did Yahshua preach every day or some days? He preached every day. Well, you have no empirical evidence of that. Well, if his Talmudim did that, so did he. It says in the book of Mark, Marcus Lucas, Mark, in the book of Mark chapter 16. Hallelujah. And we know that this was after the burial and the resurrection of Yahshua. Mark 16 verse 20. Mark 16, verse 20. It says this. And they went forth and preached everywhere. They preached everywhere that was to preach. Yeshua HaMashiach working with them and confirming the word with signs following. So be it, may it be all fulfilled. So if they went everywhere teaching the word of Yah. So if one came to the city of Jefferson in this whole 900 plus population of this city. And if one preaches just on the Shabbat, and if one preaches for a year, it's only 52 times you're going to hear that voice. They preach day and night, every single day. Why? Because that's the way they were taught. Well, how do I know they were taught that way? Well, the evidence is in the book of Luke. Lucas chapter 19 and verse 47. This should be the catalyst here. Luke 19 and verse 47. And it says, and he, who is that talking about? Is it Yahshua HaMashiach? Sure it is. And he, and he, and he, and he taught daily. Again, we go back to that concept daily. Luke 19, 47. And Yeshua HaMashiach, he taught daily. He taught every day. He preached every day. He had service every day. He taught daily, daily. Yeah. And he taught daily. He taught daily in Beit HaMikdash. He taught daily in the assembly. He taught daily. Does it say that? He taught daily in the assembly, but the chief Kohen and the scribes and the chief of the people sought to destroy him. Here, this man preached daily. He taught every single day. And those that heard that, those that supposed to be the spiritual leaders of God, is they wanted to destroy him. He taught daily. He did not teach just on the Shabbat. He taught daily. He was there every day. They had no power of authority to resist them. He will walk in there, take charge, and he would teach, and he would preach, he would teach, he would preach daily. Does it say daily? And he taught daily? So how is it this is a tradition of Christendom? It was established among the Hebrew Israelites from the beginning. We should meet daily. We should have wise men to teach daily. We should have wise daughters to teach daily. A mother teaches her daughter daily. A father teaches his son. He always teaches his son. I don't care what it is. He teaches his son. Teach him how to throw a football, even though the daddy does not throw a football. He teaches him how to throw one. Daddy may not can shoot basketball. He should shoot that ball, boy. Talk to me. Does it say he did it on Shabbat or daily? He did it daily. He taught daily. We should gather daily. This is not a Christian tradition. This is the Hebrew Israelite tradition. Hallelujah. Okay, look at the Luke 21, 37. Again, I want to have, let every word be established in the mouth of two or three witnesses. All right? In the book of Lucas 21, verse 37. It says about Yahshua. So we don't have to have assembly at nighttime, do we? Luke 21, verse 37, you have that? It says, and in the nighttime or daytime. It says in the 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 daytime he was teaching. He was teaching. He was teaching in the Beit HaMikdash. And at nighttime, you understand? He went out and he abode in the mount that is called Mount Olive. So all during the day he taught and preached. And when the night season came, he would find himself in deep prayer in the high places with Almighty Yah. So even the concept of having service at night, day and night he taught. This is not something done by the pagan whorehouse. This is the tradition of the Hebrews. He taught them in the daytime and in the nighttime. He was still a way to refresh himself, to embellish in the great word of power that he is and was, that he knew that it was Yah. It was not an act of flesh. The daytime he taught. It did not say on the Shabbat they did it. It says in the daytime. See, that's why people of ignorance, they pronounce things in ignorance and they don't even know because they haven't searched the Torah. To see what if what they're saying is faithful to Torah. What I'm saying is faithful. What I'm saying is truth. All right, I will proceed then. You're not saying much, man. Okay. Quickly in Matithya, Matthew 26:55. Matthew 26:55. Yahshua knew that it was his time. It was time for him to be impaled. Matithya 26:55, it says in the same hour. Said Yahshua HaMashiach, he said this to the multitudes. This is what he says. He said, you come out against me as a thief with swords and staves to take me. You come to kill me. He says, I sat daily. Does he say that? He did not say I sat on the Shabbat, does he? He said, I sat daily with you teaching where? In the bed of Yah. This is stupid how men think and think they're wise. He said, I sat daily in the house. I sat daily in your temple. I use that for expedience. In your temple, and you did not even lay hands on me. So did he preach one day or daily? That's why they went everywhere and they preach every day. They assemble every day. 2 or 3, 10, 20, 30, 50, 500, 600. They assemble every day and the word of Yah was taught and preached. He said, I preach daily. I preach daily in your bed. I was there every day teaching and preaching. Why didn't you take me then? If I was wrong then, why do you wait now? He preached daily. Just like Shaul. And in all his preaching, what was he doing? Warning them. That's why Shaul said, I warn you day and night. 3 years. Every day. Every night. I preach. It didn't matter if any preaching ability he could preach every. I can preach every single day. I don't need no text or no subject. Every day I can preach. Every day. And that's just the truth. I can. Every day. Well, my friend, I know it says that, but is there a witness to that? Well, Mark 14:49, the book of Mark. I want to dispel that ignorance in the minds of Yah's people. The stupidity of, I have seen men take one scripture and a word out of that and think they have wisdom of what that Ketuv is saying. That's dumb. He says in Mark 14:49, I'm pointing out these words because they're vital to understand. He says, I was daily with you in Beit HaMikdash. Is that what it says? He was daily in the bed of Yah. I know that we may not think that this is sound for us, but it is. We need to have the daily bread daily. He said, I was daily in the house of Yah doing what? Teaching. Teaching. That's what he says. Teaching. And you took me not, but the kitzvei hachodash must be fulfilled. What you all are doing to me is what the prophet said you would do. It has to be fulfilled. So he preached. Well, why did he preach? He warned them what scripture said. And they went against that. Yah warned us about ourselves, and we go against him. We go against him. He said, I was with you daily. He was with them daily, not lollygagging, grinning and skinning and jabbing and shuck bucking. He was there teaching. He was preaching. And there were people all the day long in and out. This one going to the market, knowing that they must supply the need of the house. And they would sit there and no clock on there, no watch on their wrist to tell time. Huh? And then she would leave out and go and take care of that affair. In that evening in the tabernacle, she would go back. He was there still teaching. Daily he taught. Daily he preached. Daily they had service. Daily they gathered. There should be a gathering of Israel daily. We should gather, we should gather. People gather around the damn hog table. They gather to watch television. They gather to watch the same damn thing every Wednesday, every Thursday, and every Friday. Family gathering, they gather. You tell me Israel don't gather daily? It's sick. That's what he said, he gathered daily. He taught daily, teaching in the synagogue. Hallelujah. Every single day he taught, and the Shilishim, they taught every single day. Yisrael, they taught every single day. Every single day. Hear this in Acts 18, the book of Acts 18, verse 11. Acts 18, 11. Acts 18, 11. And this is Shaul with Priscilla and Aquila. But he says this in Acts 18 and 11. And he continued. So when someone continues, is there a cessation in that? A continuous is, it never stops, right? And he continued three, there a year, see, a year and 6 months. He continued. He stayed just for the Shabbat, for 25 teachings. Nah, he was there for a year and 6 months teaching the word of Yah among them. Every day he taught. Every day he labored. In his infirmities he speaks about it. In his body failing him, he still preached and he taught. We need that today above all things. We need that. He said, well, a year and 6 months he continued. He stayed there and he taught. For that many days. You think that most of these sermonette men would be out in 2 weeks. They can go to their sermonette books and all of that. I got thousands of messages in my home that I print out scripture like this and I just laminate them. I just scripture. I can go back and preach every last one of them over every time and it'll be a different message. I got thousands. I got messages that I preached when I was a young, stupid lad. I was stupid then. I'm just ignorant now. I'm ignorant when it comes to the wealth of Yah's truth. A prideful man will say, well, I'm not. You silly man. I'm unlearned. So much I don't know. That's why I must search daily, continuously. For all that time, you think he just sat there and sipped tea and ate bread, now he preached day and night, continued without ceasing, that they may hear the mighty power of the word of Yah. 1 year and 6 months, even in the kingdom, even those that are before Yah, it just shows you how stupid men are. The Torah tells us in Revelation, Giliana, Revelation, he talks about those that are martyred, those that are blessed, who have suffered for Yahshua HaMashiach. Revelation chapter 7, verse 15. Now this is what it says. We know what Now, what do we think worship is? The word shachah is to fall prostrate, to bow, to surrender all. That's what it means. We come to the Be'ah to be taught. Shabbat is a time to remember of shachah, to fall prostrate, to cry, and to worship Yah, because we don't need anyone. We have been taught in the course of the week, and then the Ruach brings life to all this abundance of riches. You ever had a meal that you can really taste it two or three days later? That's a shown of meal. Give me some fried fish. Love it. Who was I talking to the other day? I said, man, I could eat fried fish every day. Was that you? Y'all said, no. Sure we were. Had a blowout too. I said, man, fried fish. I said, I don't know about fried chicken, but fried fish. Every day. I can eat it. Well, it's not healthy for you. I'll stop it. I said, what I can eat every day? Fried chicken. Bojangles. Hallelujah. It says in Revelation 7:15, now these are those that are martyred for Yah, for Yahshua. Therefore, are they before the throne, the chaseh of Yah, and they serve him day and night in his sukkah, in his temple. They serve him day and night. Day and night. Day and night. And he that sits on the chaseh shall dwell among them. That should be the heart of Yisrael. It should be a time that we could come in here, that from our weary labor, take off our shoes and sit. And there's someone in here, if it's nothing but reading the Torah. Why is Zachin just reading? Hallelujah. Therefore are they, and he's extolling on the Torah of Yazdo that the place is for. You think men will do that? There's no glamour to that. Because they want self-motivate, they want self-esteem. And that's the truth. And then when they see that one comes in, there are two or three, isn't it? And then they're shown of what they will call, quote in the days, is chachi-chach. Well, we're not having church. And then when that one is reading, it brings to him this ecstasy of great spiritual strength, because he knew that Yahshua, he knows that Yahshua is in the midst. In my ignorance, I would teach like this. And the Torah of Yah says, just talking like that. Nobody but us, she and I. And she would say to me, do you have to talk like that? I said, sure I do. The Melechim of Yah, they were all in that little place in our house. I say, you see them sitting there on the couch? One sitting back there on the back of the couch with his feet up. You know what my neighbor came and said to me one day? He said, preacher man, I can hear you in there. And I just come over to your house and I just stand there and I listen to you. I put me in paper thin shacks, come on. He said, I can put me into the wall and I can hear you out here. He said, I just stand there and listen to you. Where two or three gathered in his name. And that's the way it should daily, they worship Yah day and night, all day, every day, day and night. I'm not going to read this, but in the book of Numbers, Bimidbar 28, read that whole chapter, number 20. It talks about the daily offerings and the daily zebach, or the sacrifices unto Yah. I want to read this in 2 Chronicles 8 and 13. Second Chronicles. I want to conclude here in a moment. 2 Chronicles 8:13. It says, even after a certain rate every day or daily, this is the daily requirement of the offering according to the commandments of Moshe, and on the Shabbat, and the new moon, and the solemn feast, and three times in a year, even the feast of unleavened bread, and the feast of weeks, and the feast of tabernacles. There were offerings that were done daily. That's what worship is. That's what shachah is. There was those things that were done daily by the Kohan, and they had to do it daily. And there was no man that allowed the offerings to go up like Shlomo, the riches, and the great vast of his wealth. and the offerings unto Almighty God. This is a daily thing. We're not just going to have bread on the Shabbat. We need to be refortified daily. We need to hear the Torah of Yah. We need to hear the teaching every day. In our little gatherings, two or three, Yahshua is in the midst. And we there in his name. We should be taught. You don't have to come in here. It's a beautiful thing that we can assemble ourselves to fellowship on a night like this, Yisrael. Hallelujah, hallelujah. It's a great blessing. We should do this. I want to read this out of the book of Sirach. Write it down. If you don't have the book, Sirach 47. I want to read verse 1, then I want to drop down to verse 8 and 9. This has great value here. It talks about the great gifts and offerings of these great men. It says, and after him, Nathan rose up and he prophesied in the time of David. He said, what would be, he spoke of the great beauty and the what Yah would do in that time, that era among his people. Sirach 47:8. And all that he did, he gave todah and praises to the Kodash one, the Most High Yah, with words of honor. Now listen now, this is important. With words of honor, he's saying praises with all of his heart. Do we sing praises? Come on, listen now. We sing it when we come in here. Hell, some of us so grumpy and so moody, we don't know how to sing to Yah. Hear this now. And he's saying praises with all of his heart. Don't give me that we sing praises with all of our heart. We are stiff as cardboards. We get aroused on some fat back and chitlins, but not on truth. He's saying praises with all of his heart. And he loved his maker. He loved Yah. Oh, I know I love him. Oh, liar, shut up. And this is what he did. Because he loved Yah, he placed singers before the altar. For what reason? That by their voice, that they may make sweet melodies. He placed singers. That they may make sweet melodies. How often? And daily singing praises in their song. Every day they gathered. Praise the name of Yah. We lift up his name. Praises to Yah. Hallelujah. Before the bed, before the offering throne of Yah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. The beautiful voice of the Baptist Zion with the prophecy of song. They did it daily. They sing. Is not singing part of worship? Well, let's prove this in the book of Ephesians. We must do the same thing. This is what he did. We don't even do this what it says. It says in Ephesians chapter 5, verse 19. Same thing Sirach says, speaking to yourself in Tehillim and with Hallel praises and spiritual songs and making melody in your heart to Yah. See, that's what gathering every day does. We gather in Yahshua's name, Ephesians chapter 5, verse 19. We should do it daily. We should sing daily. You know, the children will come to me and say, you're going to sing? I say, oh, I don't feel like it today. Ma'ak, you see, but you're a little young, and they rise up, and they look so disappointed. It should be a great honor to come in Yah's house that you can sing. But we don't really love our Maker with our heart. It says he loved him with all his heart. And that's what he did daily. And this is what we should do, as Shaul tells us in Ephesians. Hallelujah. Praise us to Yah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's just that. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. I don't have to worry about no note. That's your problem. You're worrying about a note.
We're dead as hell.
Someone tell you, dead, man. You don't, that ain't me, preach. I'll sing. Oh, you stop that. I was in the world, I get down on it. Yeah, I boogie down. You understand? And I have much more zeal for y'all than I had out there. We're dead because we're not eating the daily bread. And let no damn unlearned, ignorant individual tell you that having service on Monday or Tuesday, Wednesday or Thursday, Friday or Saturday, Sunday or Monday, that that's some tradition of the whole house. It's not. It should be, that's a part of our heritage. Daily teaching. Daily it should be. Teaching. That's why these false revivals in America sprung up. Did they have service one night? They will have service for years in one little town, day and night. That's not originality with, that didn't originate with what we call Christendom. It originated with the people of Yah. Hallelujah. I read that to conclude all this. We that love Yah, this is what we must do in Yahkahan, John 4:23. We in this hour. Yahshua says, but the hour comes and now is when the true worshipers shall worship the Abba and Ruach and in truth. And the Abba seeks such to Shaha to worship him. That we're in that hour. That's what a true worship is. Not this formality or ritualism. We think we're so spiritually enlightened. You're not. Because your fruit will be evident of your spiritual enlightenment. Verse 24, Yah is Ruach, and they that worship him must worship him in Ruach and in truth. That's how we worship him. That's what he's seeking. And those who may declare the power of the truth, day and night. We don't live the truth just on the Shabbat. We live it day and night. You have service every day. That's the way it should be. You don't think you're wise, you need to learn to be quiet and listen and search out what the Torah says before you speak. Wise men always ponder before he speaks. He listens to what his answer is, and then he speaks. I spoke today to this man that came here to confound him. He couldn't even understand the excellence of my speech. It was so precise. It was with such melodrama that he couldn't even understand that. Yeah, I talk like that. Because I want to show him you have nothing. Don't even try to impress me, man. He had enough respect that he got humble and he was quiet and he was nervous. He was trembling. It's a beautiful thing. He has more than men that say they love Yah. There'll be men that rise up against me. Well, you ain't that. Go to hell, fool. Last verse I'm going to close with. Hear this. I'm not going to even tell you where it's at. It speaks of Jehoshaphat. It says that on the fourth day, they assembled themselves in the valley of Berechiah. For what? To have service. And there they bless Yah. And therefore today the name is still called Berechiah. They assembled themselves on the fourth day. So every day is the day that we worship Yah. The Shabbat is a time of remembering to Zakah HaShabbat and keep it set apart. That we rest in the beauty of what has been taught unto us. This is not our Wednesday night service or what we call Chat Ve'imat, Yom Rivi'i. It is not the tradition of the whole house. This is what our forefathers and the leaders of the nation of Yisrael, the power of this truth, they had to teach it every day, everywhere, in order for Yisrael to hear. So we should preach every day, and that's the way it should be in the house of Yah. There should be a messenger stand before the people of Yah. There's nothing but to read the Torah and to bring wisdom of Torah to understanding. The daughters of Tizayon, at least they do gather in the morning, sing a song, and have a few words. That is a blessing. You understand? And so if you got a moody spirit or a nutty spirit, you can get that. You can check yourself against what has been said of the song. That's why when you begin to learn how to sing the, your song, suffering spiritual songs, you don't realize the healing that it is. That's the way they used to do it in the days. As a young lad, I remember a lot of things. I say this in my clothes. I would see my grandmother and the old women and how they would sing and how they would do. I'm a little old boy, but I remember those things. They go in a house, someone's sick, and then somebody just get this thing and just
It's gonna be all right. Gonna be all right. Gonna be all right. They go to the bin, see cutting coat and sick it. Wouldn't get to singing like that. It's gonna be all right. Don't you worry, little child. It's gonna be all right. Gonna be all right. Yes, it is. As a young boy like these kids, I can remember those things. No, I can remember day from day. I can remember what I did 3 weeks ago on today. But I can remember those poignant times. Don't worry about a thing. Gonna be alright. Gonna be alright. Don't let it be a man. Some of y'all may know what I'm saying, you that are listening, but that's the way it would be. And they would sing. And even the one that was in deep sickness, you would sense the glow and the beauty of their face. You would see the, but baby, set me up a little bit. I feel all right. We should sing to ourselves in spiritual song daily. That's worship. We don't even do that. And it's wrong. May Yabarak you all Yisrael. We greet you all. We have not discontinued our Kitvi Emet. You want to come and give me some help? I need some help. I'm going to close the night from here. I got so much to do. What damn thing? Put it on there. Put it on there. Oh, gab and no gift. Let us stand to our feet. Everything is going to be all right. I'm telling you, it's going to be all right. Israel. We don't hear out above. It's going to be all right. In all things we do, give you praises. Your sure mighty name. Bless your nation, your people. Touch us all. Your healing power upon your people. Our precious Ach Jakin Jacob there in Jacksonville. Touch him. And our Ach Jacob there in Texas. I bless you for that precious Ach. So kind and precious. He is to the labor of this work all these years. Bless him, his wife, his children. In his travel, I know he travels much and busy. He works, Yah. But Yah, his gifts are so tremendous and a great help. Bless him and all of our friends. Akmikaya, his family is so kind, so precious. Bless all Yisrael, Yah. All those that are listening, our Ak. Davis there in California, our Zakein Tayon, Yah. And every Ak and Achotim. Bless them all in Yahshua's name. Take our family home safely. Watch over them in Yahshua's name. Bless the Ach, our Zachin, for the labor today. Ach Shimri, bless his body. Heal him. Give him the desire, the gift of his heart. Yah, I pray that above all things. In Yahshua's name, and we give your name the praises, and we barak you in all things. We shout hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.